Thank you. Good evening, everybody.
Test.
Good evening, everybody. Is it a good evening? Yes, it is, because it's the last Wednesday of the year and we can finally get to say goodbye to your children in 2 days, okay? So we are definitely on the countdown, but we want to thank you all for being here tonight. We have been given instruction just to warm up the atmosphere with a couple of songs. Is that all right with you? So our first song today is I Just Keep Trusting My Lord. Amen? Hallelujah. After all we've been through this year, we have to keep trusting our God. Amen. So let's sing that all together. I just keep trusting my Lord. I just keep trusting. 1, 2. I just keep trusting my Lord as I walk along. Come on and sing it. I just keep trusting my Lord as He gives a song. Though the storm clouds, though the storm clouds darken the sky, or the heavenly tramp, I just keep trusting my Lord. He will never fail. Why? Because He's a faithful. He's a faithful friend. Such a faithful friend. I can count on Him to the very end. Amen. Though the storm clouds darken the sky, or the heavenly train, He's a faithful friend. Okay, He's a faithful. Come on. He's a faithful friend.
He's a faithful friend.
Such a faithful friend.
Such a faithful
Amen.
Friend.
I can count on Him.
I can count on Him.
Till the very end.
Though the storm,
though the storm clouds darken the sky, or the heavenly trail, I just keep trusting my Lord.
To sing one more song, My God Loves Me, because that's truth, isn't it? God really does love us, and the Bible says that nothing in heaven or on earth can ever separate us from that love. So let's declare that this night, that God really does love us. My God, 1, 2. My God loves me. Amen. Thank you, Lord. And one more time, my God loves me. My God loves me. And all the wonders I see. Amen. Big arms, the rainbow.
The rainbow shines through my window. My God loves me.
Amen. All right, let's put our hands together for our young people. Amen.
Welcome, Asdah family and friends. Good evening. You are here to bear witness to the wonderful works of our juniors today. So please sit back, sit tight. If we could also fill in the chairs, there's still a few chairs here in the aisleways. Please try to avoid hanging out in the stairway. Just a few house rules also before we begin. Bathrooms are here on my left, females on the left and males on the right. And if there is a fire, our exits are here in the back and on my far right here. And yeah, so without further ado, please Welcome our year 9s and 10s as they perform for you their production on the 10 Commandments. Malo. Kia ora.
Bula vinaka.
Malo elele.
Talofa lava.
Kia ora ana.
Whakalofa lahi atu.
Greetings and welcome, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Tivinia.
And my name is Taylor. We would now like to invite the flags to enter. These flags represent the diverse nationalities of our Asdah community.
Please be seated for our national anthem. Please stand for our national anthem. I now would like to invite Pastor Moy to come forward and bless us with our beautiful night by praying to God.
May you close your eyes and I'll lead with a word of prayer. Our loving and amazing Father, Thank you for bringing us here safely. Thank you for your unceasing love that you have shown to our school, our staff, our families and whānaus throughout this challenging but successful year. So Lord, tonight, I want to commit this production to you. It's about 10 commandments. And it's my prayer tonight for everyone here. May they see it not as a list of commandments, but in the words of Jesus Christ, he said it's all about love. I pray for the amazing students that they are going to perform. We ask, Lord, that you give them courage and strength so that they can perform with the best of their ability, so that anyone here tonight will go home with blessings from you. Bless us, everyone here tonight. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor. My mic is up. Thank you, Pastor Moy. So once again, welcome to the Year 9 and 10 production. It has been a challenging year with COVID and lockdown, but despite that all, God has sustained us all with the gifts and talents.
So our production is about our loving God, and if you love him, keep his commandment. Thank you.
It was good, thanks. Today we learned about Pacifica mythology. We also watched a movie to show it. By the way, Nana.
Yes, my grandson?
Did you know that there is over 70 gods in Pacifica mythology? 70!
Ah, my son. There's only one true God, the God of the heavens and the earth, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. It's here in the Bible. It says that there's only one true God that we should worship. In Exodus 20, we have the Ten Commandments given to Moses. We worship only one God.
Oh, banana. The movies.
Look here. In the New Testament, it says that Jesus said, if you love me, keep my commandments. That means God wants us to be faithful and keep his commandments. Like the people in the old times and the people in our times.
That's interesting. Do you mind if I have a more of a look into this?
Knock, knock!
Hello, Andrew.
Hi, Auntie. I just came to see if you're still trying to come play tag with us.
Nah, I'm all good, G.
Bro, what? All my life, you wasted my time coming here.
G, remember how in the movie it said that there's like many, many gods?
Yeah?
Well, guess what, bro? There's only one God.
Hey?
Yo, it says right here, the first commandment. Thou shalt not have any other gods before me.
Bro, no other gods? What do you mean?
It means that that means there is only one God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Let's be joyful and adore him.
Hail thee as the sun.
Yes. No other gods before him. So, yes. No other gods. So, what does the second commandment say?
It says, thou shalt have no other idols before me.
Yes, idols. What are idols?
You don't know what idols are, bro?
Nuh-uh.
Oh, bro, I gotta take your secret. I don't know what idols are either. Shit. Oh, let's go ask my nana. Yo, nana, what are idols?
Anything can be an idol. It's when you spend most of your time on it, bowing down to it like a statue. But if you honor it more than the God of the universe...
Oh, that's my phone. Let me just get that real quick. Hello? Bro, you called me for no reason. Sorry about that.
See? Your phone. That can be an idol. Like TV or money. Just things you put before your love of God. Spending countless of hours in front of it can be an idol.
That's crazy, Nana.
Yeah, I never thought a phone or a TV could be an idol.
Yes, that's right, my son. Both you and your friend have a lot to learn. Do not bow down to idols.
Does that mean I have to give up my laptop or PlayStation?
If you're putting those things before God, then yeah, bro, you probably should do something about that.
Oh my God.
You shouldn't say that.
Say what?
Misuse the name of the Lord, bro.
Bro, what do you mean?
That's the third commandment. Thou shalt not take the Lord of the name in vain.
And what does that mean?
You wouldn't like it when people use your name carelessly. So why would you use God's? Call his name whenever you're in trouble. His name is to be honored and glorified.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I said good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The Bible says that there is no name
higher than Jesus Christ. Amen. So we thought we would bring the swagger tonight so that we can call upon his name. Are you with us? Are you with us? Choir, are you with me? Let's call on his name. Here we go. Come on, come on, sing. Now the Bible promises that in the name of Jesus, sins can be forgiven. The Bible promises that in the name of Jesus, diseases can be healed. Amen. The Bible promises that in the name of Jesus, demons tremble. So why don't you join with us as we call his name? Come on, sing it.
Call his name whenever you're in trouble and you start to stumble. There's power in his name. Call his name, call his name. This world can be so crazy. Meet the Lord daily. He'll save you from your pain. Call his name, call his name. Whenever you're in trouble and you start to stumble, there's power in his name. Call his name, call his name. This world can be so crazy. Meet the Lord daily. He'll save you from your pain.
All right, all right, all right, all right, all right, choir. Come on, we're not fully there yet tonight, choir. We're not fully there yet. Parents and families, we want you to join us. Is that all right? Yeah. All right, come on, let's call on his name one more time. Sing it, choir.
Call his name, whenever you're in trouble and you start to stumble, there's power in his name. Call his name, call his name. This world can be so crazy. Meet the Lord daily, he'll save you from your pain. Call his name, whenever you're in trouble and you start to stumble, there's power in his name. Call his name, call his name. This world can be so crazy. Keep the Lord daily, he'll save you from your pain.
I've never thought of it like that. Thanks for teaching me about the commandments.
The next commandment is about the Sabbath. It says that 6 days thou shalt do all the labor, but on the Sabbath second, the seventh day, is the Sabbath day for the Lord thy God.
What does that mean?
It means you can do whatever you want on all other 6 days. On Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Whatever you want. Work, play tennis, do rugby, but on the seventh day is for the Lord.
Oh, yes. Yes, remember the Sabbath day.
Day. Absolutely, bro. Jesus told us to remember, just in case we forgot.
Oh, so it looks like we're at number 5 now. What does the Bible say?
It says, honor thy mother and thy father, that thy days may be long upon the land.
Man, but my parents are always too busy. I told them to come to my rugby game, right?
Yeah?
And they said they're too busy working.
Bro, maybe they're too busy because they're trying to put food on the table, you know? Maybe they're too busy because they're trying to pay for your school fees. But you still got to respect them by coming to school, getting good grades, and also helping with the hours around the house. Am I right, parents?
Yeah. Man, but I never do fit hours.
You should listen to this then.
soul so weary. When troubles come and my heart burden be, and I am still awake here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me.
What a wonderful song. Makes me think of how much my parents have done for me.
Do you want to hear number six?
Okay.
It says, thou shalt not murder.
I've never murdered in my life. That's easy.
Bro, you can hurt people with your words. Like, words can be cut through people's heart and, like, poison. And really, like, hurt them on the inside.
What do you mean?
Look at social media today, bro. Some words that people put in there can cause mental unwellness. People can really get destroyed by your words.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
Look at this.
Whoa, yeah. I'm the number six, the murderer. deep breath, 6, 7, 9. Oh, let's get it.
No murder, no hate, no murder, no hate. We keep it positive up in this place. No murder, no hate, no murder, no hate. We keep it positive up in this place.
No murder. It's the topic of discussion with these lyrics that I'm busting. Hit your head like a concussion, but percussion. With the bass and the vibe in the place, we on fire from them high 119.
As it's finest.
As they try to rewind this, but it's mother murder. Don't tell me you ain't heard of hate in the heart. Place the drama stock. That's how we set apart that we don't walk in the dark. No murder, no hate. When they win, we celebrate. Polynesian and we great. Let them up in our mistakes. Showcase the love that our God has talked about. When it's on, we walk it out. Never fall without a doubt.
No murder, no hate. No murder, no hate. Keep it positive up to this place. This place. No murder, no hate. No murder, no hate. Keep it positive up to this place.
In the place, be the topic with the flows, and I'm dropping, rep the name, ain't no stopping in the coffin, no one drop. Hip hop, don't flop, run the game to the top, let Teddy put it on the spot. White line in game time, we pay grind, that same shine, that great mind, that gate mind, that fade rhyme, no K time. Jared the provider told us never kill a hate, so I will aim at heaven's gate. All in love, we celebrate, no murder.
No murder, no hate, no murder, no hate.
We keep it positive up in this place, this place.
No murder, no hate,
no murder, no hate. We keep it positive up in this place, this place.
To be honest, that was a bit scary.
Bro, we gotta look out for each other.
Yeah, you're right. Looks like we're number 7. What does the Bible say?
It says, thou shalt not commit adultery.
What does adultery mean?
I don't know. There's Pastor Sarah. Let's ask him.
Repent and be baptized. Repent and be baptized. Oh, boys.
Amen, sir.
How's
Amen.
It going? Hey, Vita, how's it going? John C., what's going on, man? What's going on?
Yeah, we're just going through the Bible, right?
Yeah.
And we saw this verse that we didn't understand.
It what says, did it say?
Thou shalt not commit adultery.
Well, I can help you with that. You see, it's all about being faithful. It's all about being what?
Faithful.
Faithful. It's all about being faithful. When there is no faithfulness, we can commit adultery. And so the only way that we can do that is that we can look to God and see how he is faithful to us. From there, a man and a woman can be faithful in their covenants. And when they do, they commit
adultery.
Yeah, come on, man. So let us look to God as the model of our faithfulness.
Yeah. Praise the Lord, sir. Hallelujah.
Yes, he is.
And after that, I'm never getting married.
Well, why not?
So I didn't have to ever break that commandment. It's obvious.
You'll be the first one to have a girlfriend.
I won't.
What about the other day? I saw you talking to her at the shops. Boo, that's the 9th commandment. Bear false witness and lying.
Bear false witness? Bear false witness isn't lying.
It means telling false things.
Nah. Let's go back to number 8.
Boo, you gotta make a change in your life. Make a change.
After that, you know, I think I'm changing slowly, you know, transforming slowly. I've got to look in the mirror and make a change. We skipped to number 9, right? But what about number 8?
Number 8 is about stealing. Thou shalt not steal.
Man, that's easy. I've never stole anything in my life.
We took some oranges from the neighbor's tree yesterday.
That's not stealing. I was just helping them, so the oranges don't come and litter the ground.
But the Bible says we shouldn't steal, though.
Like what?
Now that I think about it, my dad often brings home toilet paper from his work.
Bro, what? Are you serious right now? Oh my days.
Yeah, but my dad's work has heaps of it, so we're all good.
Yeah, but it doesn't matter. Stealing is stealing. Even if it's something as small as toilet paper, your dad's work has heaps of it, it's still stealing.
Yeah, you're right. But you could also steal stuff like money, ideas...
And time!
True, I never thought of it like that.
Man, I guess you never think. You know? That's why God gave us a brain to think.
Just because you're smart.
Everyone steals. No one pays attention to how the other person feels. Whether it's a small 20 cents off the ground or sneaking into a house without a sound, we all do actions we try to conceal, but in the end, all will be revealed.
Stealing comes in many ways. While people try to rephrase how it looks good at first gaze, but in the end, you're stuck in the face. For instance, our boy stole an apple from Apple Stand, and that looks good enough mafia boss top in command. The Bible.
Proverbs 6 talks about taking things and not yours, and how your punishment is what the Lord ensures. The Bible says that anyone who steals must pay back sevenfold to the owner in bundles of food or coins of gold. Commandment 8 in the Bible commands us not to steal. The instruction is clear and every part of it is real.
Instead of stealing, we should focus on giving and sharing with others. We have a better way of living. 2 Corinthians 9 verse 7, people who give have a high place in heaven. Proverbs 19, giving to others is giving to the Lord, and it's us afterwards that reap the reward. The Bible tells you to give kindly to others, and as in Jesus Christ, we are sisters and brothers.
We shouldn't give reluctantly because we were told to. Rather, we should give because kindness is what we hold to. When we give instead of steal, we show others of our selfless appeal, and therefore it's them that our acts can heal. You shall not steal, Commandment 8. Overcome this sin and I'll see you at heaven's gate.
So, we're at commandment number 10, and it says, if I remember correctly, do not covet.
What does covet mean?
Bro, I don't know what coveting means. Let's go ask Nana. Oh. Hey, Nana, what does it mean to covet?
Thou shalt not covet, you shouldn't get working. Testing. Thou shalt not covet means you shouldn't get jealous or envious of what other people have. Whether they're prettier than you or they have more nicer clothes than you, just don't worry and just be happy with what you have and praise the Lord for what you have. Instead of getting jealous or envious of what other people have, just be grateful and focus your time on praising the Lord. Attitude of gratitude to heal us from coveting others. Thou shalt not covet thy neighbors.
hot out here. No, I don't mind though. I'm just glad to be free. You know what I'm saying?
Take the shackles off my feet so I can dance. I just wanna praise you. I just wanna praise you. You broke the chains, now I can lift my hands. And I'm gonna praise you. I'm gonna praise you.
In the corners of my mind, I just can't seem to find a reason to believe that I can pray free. Cause you see, like a hope is gone, but as I lift my hands, I understand that I should praise you through my circumstance.
Take the shackles off my feet so I can dance. I just wanna praise you. I just wanna praise you.
Let me think. Using my massive intellect, I can predict that there are no more commandments left. What do we do now?
I don't know, but I just feel like I've uncovered something new. I feel so joyful, you know, and I feel joyful, yeah?
Mm.
Joyful,
yeah.
Joyful.
Yeah.
Lord, we adore thee.
Also, wait. Now that I think about it, the Ten Commandments are split into two sections. The first four talk about how we should honor God, and the last six talk about how we should honor others. Let's be joyful and let's praise the Lord.
We've come to the end of our year 9 and 10 Ten Commandments production. You know, we had a very difficult time trying to get kids to school. You know, school, children were away, people were sick, people had, you know, that COVID bug, like, because COVID came, it was like an excuse to stay home. But parents, those of you who persevered, it was really building students' resilience. Kids who could come every day and still get a production done. They are your children. But parents, one of the things that I'd like to say tonight is if you want your students to do well, then you need to bring them to school. Attendance is a big issue. And you know, tonight there are some kids who didn't turn up. That's why we had the someone announced from the back. But you know, other kids stood up. Some kids didn't know what to do, and then somebody else said, I'll do it. You know, building the gifts and talents of our students while they are young. And you know, when we decided on the Ten Commandments, someone said, what production are we going to do? And I thought, we learn in year 9 about Ten Commandments. That is something we learn. So I thought, let's put it into actions. Because when your children grow up, and wherever they go, it will be implanted in their heart. The Ten Commandments are about love. If you love me, keep my commandments. And so we have planted that seed in every child so that when they leave school, that they will have that embedded in their hearts. So parents, thank you. Thank you for coming tonight. And thank you for supporting us. You can see the joy on their faces. It's not easy trying to look after them, you know, trying to get this done, but we made it. And so let's give them all a big hand. I'd like to ask our principal, is she here? Our principal, is she there? Okay, we'll ask Mrs. Teolilo to come forward, and she will just say a few words and render us our benediction tonight.
Good evening, everyone, and let's put our hands together for all the kids behind us. I know you've acknowledged them. There are also a couple of people that I would like to say thank you to before we finish tonight. Mrs. Fuamatu, our Deputy Principal, Pastoral Care. She is amazing at putting productions together. And this was done in about 5 weeks. Because we knew how important it was to give you parents something, especially in the year of ups and downs that we've been through. We want you to see your kids up the front, you know, singing and dancing and giving a positive message about God in a world where it's not fashionable anymore to have these values. So thank you. And Mrs. Fuamatu, she said to me, do not thank me, but let's just put our hands together to thank you. There are also a couple of tech people and staff people around. I'm going to embarrass them all and call them up the front. Gershon, don't hide. This is Gershon in year 10. He's the mic man. He's the mic guy. Okay. It's part of the tech team. And didn't we have those two brilliant boys and the grandmother? They were fantastic too. And every staff member that is here, we thank them also for the time and the effort. I know, your kids might have come home and said, oh, we got a growling today and all of that, but it's the standard to pull it up, to pull it up.
Sure. Yeah, I just want to say thank you. I've forgotten to say thank you to Mr. Teo Lilo, who's been behind the scenes, all of this, the lights. Can we give him a big hand? Also, I just want to thank Mr. President, who's helped also make it possible for us to have the backdrop there. Let's give him a big hand. And I think just to all our staff members, they've done a wonderful job in supporting us. So, you know, when we do things at Asdah, we like to start on time. And I think we've only kept you for an hour. So hopefully you'll go home and have time with your families. So please, whenever we have a show, just to remind you, we start on time, okay? So come early. Thank you.
Spoken like a true teacher. Thank you, Mrs. Formatu. Lastly, parents, families, whānau, Asdah wouldn't be Asdah without your children. So three cheers before I pray. Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Hooray!
Let's bow our heads for prayer. Heavenly Father, what an awesome opportunity to come and enjoy the evening. There's been a lot of work that's gone in, but we're so grateful that our students stood up to talk about your message of love. And as everyone leaves from here tonight, we pray that they will have a safe journey home. And as we bring our year to a close, we pray that they will all have a safe year with family. And we pray all of this in Jesus' name. Amen. Good night and all the best for the end of the year.